Indonesian long race. We have about a minute until the start, so sit back and over the next 10 to 15 minutes, I'll take you through some of the highlights of the race. As you can see, I'm just pulling at some sheets, making my way to the line. I didn't make a very good start in this race. Well, I thought I hadn't made a good start in this race. I was a little bit late, and I had to bully my way through a large crowd of other boats. But I do eventually get there, and the race will start in 4, 3, 2, and as you can see, I'm still a long way from the line with a lot of boats in front of me. Doing about 6 knots, and situational awareness with one person looking is pretty hard. We have a number of boats in front of me who are all turning. And I move after that one, and I keep on changing my sails. I thought the Genoa might have been a good option, but it wasn't, so I went back to the jib. And this is where I'm just about to cross the start line. We'll follow the action here for a little bit longer. The start of the race is obviously one of the most exciting parts of it. And you can see me furiously trying to adjust and get good trim. I'm hoping to take a little bit of wind off of the boat to my port. I don't think that I'm having any effect on his sails anyway. I also notice that there's a transat in front of me, and I decide that I want to be on the windward side of him. So I will turn a little bit to get a little bit of position. And still trimming, trying to find a good path through. And I will cut back in a little bit to show you a little bit more of the start. Okay, at almost the hour mark here, we're still heading in a easterly direction, and you can see that I'm looking at a number of different boats around me with my mainsail just being a little bit about out of whack there, and we're fairly close to the leaders at this stage. Okay, so here we are looking at the turn I made. You can see that I'm just checking out who's around me. Hi Ants, the Chief, Cocos, and just plotting a course to the south. So 6 hours later, looking at the race leaders here, Cocos is in front, Nomad, which is me, Hyance, and Lactus, and we're all fairly close to each other. Some people have started to make turns. I've decided to go a bit more south and see how the conditions treat me. Okay, so I've decided on my path with Lactus just in front of me. Well, he is closer to the final, but we're still pretty close to each other. And as you can see, I think I've decided to do a similar thing to him, which is come through the islands to the south. I will have to make a small tack to get around the tip of it, whereas he won't. But it should be an interesting night's racing. And just back again to have a look at where what people are doing. Cocos has finally turned. And then we have a number of people like Dark Angel and Lactos who are following me. Dark Angel eventually peels off and decides to go the long way. And out to the west, we have a number of other boats who, like Tito and Tinzel, who went the long way round, and as you will see later, some of them have some pretty nasty bugs which force them to stop the race. Anyway, I'll come back in another little bit. Okay, and back again, and we've made it around the easterly side of the island. Still going south, up there is Lactos, and according to the leaderboard, he's still a little bit in front, but I'm a little bit south of him. So we'll come back a little bit later. And just to show the devs what the trouble was in the game, we have Hyance who has finished apparently, even though he hasn't. And this was a bug that was in this race. And in the end, four competitors had the same bug where they would log off and their time was taken as the end time and they were kicked out of the race. Anyway, I'll continue back in a moment. Okay, back again, and as you can see, we now have three competitors that have finished, except this is the bug. And yeah, we've made the turn. I've been asleep for a couple of hours. So even though Lactos there looks like he's winning, while he's in front of me, it's not actually the case. Anyway, we're heading up the side. I'm in second, Lactos is in first, and we have an exciting end coming. So at the 20-hour mark, we finally catch sight of each other. And as you can see, we're very close to the finish line here. I have my Kodo up, and I'm working as hard as I possibly can to catch him and overtake him. It's the end of a long and tiring race, and although I've slept during large parts of it, this last bit was quite draining. Just kept on talking to people and pulling in sheets, making sure that everything was balanced, and just keeping an eye on him as well. Now, I'd lost any communication from him, and it wasn't until later in the race that, well, near the finish line, that I realized that he'd been indisposed and hadn't seen me catch the 1 nautical mile that I was behind him. He had the wrong sail up. He only had his jib on, and basically that slip up allowed me to get into first place and to win this race. And here I am about to cross the finish line. Hard-fought battle. I guess I got lucky this time, which was good. And so, while I get to finish and bring down the sails, others are still out on the course, and I duly wait for Lactos to come across the line. We will see that in a couple of minutes. He's not that far behind me. And the unfortunate thing is that once you finish the race, you can't actually see the leaderboard after it. I hope they fix that at some point. Anyway, my time was 21 hours, 14 minutes, and I don't know, a couple of seconds. And here he is, about to hit the line. I go up the mast so I can get a better look. And there he goes. A little pop up there as he goes over the crest of the wave. And so that is the Indonesian race for 2017.